Holding nothing back, I'm not going on the You know, it's like in Braveheart when the two armies square off on either side, you know, and they start roaring at each other. William Wallace and his crazy blue-faced band of warrior poets just begin to scream. They're totally outnumbered, they're totally outmatched, but they just begin to stir up the zeal. We're in an hour where God is stirring up the zeal in the body of Christ for the presence of the Lord. When it's no longer we're trying to hold on to a Christian America, you know, and we're trying to hold on to our little scrap of Christianity and morality. We're not going on the defense, we're going on attack. And worship is our weapon. And fasting and prayer are our weapons. And the Word of God is a two-edged sword, and it's sharp. It's our weapon. He's teaching us how to be an army, how to go from being infants in our faith to maturing and becoming an army. Jesus. The armies of Israel were terrified for 40 days as the champion Goliath came out again and again to taunt their ranks. And he would defy the armies of the living God. And he would say, "Who is this God of Jacob? Send someone to fight me." And for 40 days, they were terrified and they cowered and no one would go out. And you know the story. God sent a little shepherd boy, a teenage boy. But he had been alone with God for years and years and years, tending his father's sheep in the secret places of his life, learning how to be intimate with God. And that intimacy began to breed a confidence in him that was overwhelming. And God allowed him to defeat a lion and a bear as they came against a flock, and God began to train him. I just believe there are some of you here tonight that you've been in training. And God has allowed a lion and a bear. He's allowed you to come and to wrestle with things that are terrifying, but they're no giant, they're no Goliath. But there's a generation that's been in training, and God's going to unleash them against the giants in the land. And it's intimacy that's bred confidence and sonship in them. It's not just a teenage testosterone zeal, but it's a deep confidence that comes from intimacy with God. Lord, we press into intimacy with you tonight to know the living God, to know Jesus Christ, the Son of God, to know the Holy Spirit, to know and be known by the living God. We open ourselves up to you right now to know. Receive the love of your Father tonight. Receive the affirmation of Father as He's just putting His hands on you tonight. He's affirming you. He's shaping you. He's anointing you. He's molding you. Oh! And the weary would sprout new wings, if upon you they would lay. Prison bars are shaking. Yeah.
the Most High. There's a place of safety, but there's another part of that that some of us, because we're disconnected, it says in Ecclesiastes 4:12, the one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves, a cord of three strands is not quickly broken. And there's those who've been disenfranchised, have been disconnected in various things and places. I sense the Lord would say to you tonight that if you will step out of your comfort zone, maybe the issue's been trust, and you've been wounded, you've been hurt, but the Lord would say, just come out of the storm, into the shelter, into the secret place. And I have a sense that even though there'll be different things taught and etc. tonight and ministered to, the Lord can meet every specific need of every person that is here tonight. If you will step out from the storm, if you'll step out from the place of obscurity, of feeling disconnected, of feeling disenfranchised, and take even a step of faith. It says if you have a faith of a mustard seed, even just a teeny bit, just to move forward, that He will meet you. I sense if you move a little, He's going to move a lot. If you move a little, He's going to move a lot. So I just encourage you to step forth. We have times of ministry tonight. There's going to be different opportunities. Do not leave here. And some of us have been hurt, so we don't trust anybody. But the cord, the three-strand cord, will not be broken. Some of us need to come into community. Maybe it's not here. Maybe it's somewhere else. But you need to come into connection. Maybe it's a small group. Come for prayer. But take a step, and the Lord will meet you.
You've been bound by all kinds of irrational fears and thinking. And in the Lord's presence tonight, He's shaking the doors of those prisons. Some of you tonight are bound in different kinds of addictions, where your body feels like it needs certain chemicals to meet emotional needs. I'm going to say in the presence of the Lord and under the anointing tonight, those chains are being shaken too. And God's coming in the weight of His glory. And the weight of His glory is coming down like a yoke around your neck. And as it comes down like a yoke around your neck, it begins to crush every other yoke that's around your neck. Because there's nothing weightier and heavier than the glory of the living God. And when you begin to receive His yoke upon you, it begins to snap and crackle every other yoke and every other chain. So I just speak that tonight, a yoke-breaking anointing, as the weight of His glory comes down and rests upon you throughout the entire evening and throughout the entire week, the weight of His glory coming and breaking every other yoke and delivering you out of all your fears, all your anxieties. CJ can keep playing, but we just want to do something real quick. You can be seated for a moment. I want to invite my mom to come up. We're going to do this. We're going to dismiss our children tonight at 6 o'clock to go back. Tonight's a special night. It's the first night that we're really launching our 7 to 11-year-old classes. Who's here tonight that's 7 to 11 years old? You guys have your own special class starting tonight with a wonderful man who kind of looks like Santa Claus after he's gone, you know, on a P90X or whatever it is. This is Richard. Richard, stand up real quick. This is Mr. Richard Ivey. We're thrilled that God's put it on his heart to begin to teach and train and equip and mold our little children. And Richard, I love him. He's not here to babysit kids. He's not here to play Twister or Romper Room with them. He's there to teach them that the Holy Spirit that lives in them is not a junior or mini Holy Spirit. He is a full-sized Holy Spirit. And he's able to do everything through little children that he can do through the most mature of us. So I'm just so excited that the kids at Big House are going to start learning the kingdom culture of power and intimacy and walking in the fullness of their identity from a young age. And part of this transition, there's more good news. My mother, Mary Kate, the lovely mom, she is really, taking on a labor for this church for the past 2 years now. We had a great need. There was nobody to be with our children from ages 2 up to about 7 years old. And it was a real hindrance to the church being able to grow, young families feeling like they could plug in here. There's nothing for our kids. And mom really stepped up 2 years ago and said, you know what, whatever it takes, I'm going to do it. And incredible things have happened over the past 2 years, and there's been an awesome space for our children to come and to learn about God and for you parents to be able to come and drop your kids off and be able to experience the presence of the Lord. And tonight, there's an awesome shift going on. Mom knew that this was for a season. It wasn't a long-term calling, and we've been praying for a while, asking the Lord to reveal who's that person, Lord, that you put it on their heart that this is their call. This is what they want to do. They want to raise up little ones. And just want to share real quick about what's going on and who the Lord has brought.
Yes. I do
want to
share.
Strong connection to heaven. And so I'm new in
your hands out toward Tiva. She's got her beautiful 2-year-old daughter and her husband, and we're just so honored that this is who the Lord has brought to fill this role. Frank, would you pray for us?
Lord, we just pray for just a fresh anointing. Your word says, not by power, not by might, but by my spirit, saith the Lord. I just pray that you would just send your anointing, just send an increase, an impartation right now in the name of Jesus. And I just pray that there would be a supernatural unction and a knowing of how to minister each week and with each child, Lord God. And we just pray just your blessing upon this ministry, Father God. And I just pray that you would protect her and cover her family and just give her your peace and grace in the name of Jesus. Ladies here that went to the Unveiled conference over the weekend? Lots of you. Awesome. It was incredible. I think over 100 women in all came out over the 2 days, over Friday and Saturday. And I've just heard nothing but incredible testimonies and reports. So I want to give an opportunity for some testimonies. Karen, you want to come? You had some testimonies written down about some awesome things that happened.
Father. And I just burst out crying. I have gone through really hellish times lately, and I just didn't want to live. Did not want to live. And yet every single day, the Lord kept on telling me, you've got to live. You've got to go forward. And so, you know, Big House and everybody here has been amazing to pray and intercede for me. But today, I went back, and another gentleman from Harvest chose to intercede and pray with me today. And so we went through a lot of ministry, and I can say now that I feel that I can say, my Father loves me.
Wonderful. Friday night, from the message spoken from the